let us be discuss the compounds of boron. Compounds of boron, in that the most important compound, that is what? Borax. Borax. Borax also we called as tincal. Borax also we called as tincal. What is the general formula, chemical formula of this one? That is, we will write it as Na2B4O7 having 10 water molecules. So this is the general chemical formula, but the structural formula is different, structural based formula. So if you look at the structural based formula, structural based formula is Na2B4O5OH4 having 8 water molecules. So this is the structural based formula. How can we say that this is the structural formula? See, if you look at the structure, you have an idea. So like this, the 4 boron atoms are there, and these 4 boron atoms are bonded with the oxygens like this. And these two are also bonded with oxygen, and the 4 boron atoms are having 4 OHs. Okay, now this unit, how we have already, how many boron atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, so B4. And how many oxygens are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 center. So 5 oxygens. And how many OHs are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. That is why B4O5OH4. And it's 2 sodium, so that is why Na2B4O5OH4 8H2. So this is the structure of this one. And one more thing, in this structure, what is the hybridizations of the borons? Very, very important. In this, the 2 boron atoms, this oxygen, this boron and this boron, I mean the 2 borons which are born, which are intertwined with the oxygens. Okay, these 2 borons are undergoing sp3 hybridization. And the remaining 2 boron, these 2 borons are undergoing what? sp2 hybridization. So this is sp3 hybridized, and this is what? sp2 hybridized. Okay, clear? So next, let's move to the properties of the preparation of this one. Preparation of borax. How to prepare the borax? So the first one, from boric acid, H3BO3. So to this boric acid, if you add sodium carbonate, okay, this on heating, we will get directly Na2B4O7. And how many water molecules? 4 is 12, that means 6 water molecules will go out. So this is what first method. Next one, from colimonite. What is the formula of colimonite? Colimonite is nothing but Ca2B6O11. So this is what we call it as colimonite. Now to this colimonite, Ca2B6O11, if we add sodium carbonate, okay, if you add sodium carbonate, okay, first of all, we will get CaCO3 plus Na2B4O7 plus B2O3, sodium metaborate, NaBO2. Okay, these are the compounds will come. Now, this on hot water and further filtration, that residue, after the filtration, that the formed residue is nothing but what? CaCO3. The CaCO3 will be separated out. That supernatant solution, that filtrant, that filtrate having both Na2B4O7 plus NaBO2, sodium metaborate, both are present. Now this on further crystallization of this mixture. And the solution of these two compounds are present. This on crystallization, now the sodium Na2B4O7 will be crystallized. So we are getting Na2B4O7 in the form of crystals, solidifies. And the remaining solution, what is there? NaBO2. Okay, so we can convert easily this NaBO2 into Na2B4O7 simply by passing CO2. By passing the CO2 into this, again the sodium metaborate will convert it into what? Na2B4O7. So this is what the second method of preparation of borax from collagenite. Okay, next, properties of the borax. Properties of borax. So if you look at, if you check the borax, it is in a white crystalline solid. Okay, borax is a white crystalline solid. Next one, it is a salt of, weak acid and a strong base. How can we say it's a salt of weak acid and a strong base? So that we can confirm by hydrolysis. Na2B4O7 on hydrolysis we will get NaOH and boric acid H3PO3. So how many? 4 moles will come. So this on hydrolysis we are getting strong base and weak acid. That means it's a salt of strong base and weak acid. So that is why if you hydrolyze this borax, what is the nature of the solution? Alkaline in nature. So the aqueous solution, of borax is alkaline in nature. Very, very important. Why? Because the salt of weak acid, strong base is always be basic in nature because of anionic hydrolysis. Okay. Next, because of the formation of this base Na, strong base, suppose if this aqueous solution of borax on heated with the acids, so reaction with the acids, like HCl like this, what happened? This NaOH will react with the HCl and they form salt. So that is why we will write like this: Na2B4O7 on hydrolysis 5H2O and HCl, 2 moles of HCl, we are getting 2 moles of NaCl plus 4 moles of boric acid. So this is a reaction of borax with HCl. We are getting NaCl with the formation of boric acid. This is also one more method of preparation of boric acid. Next, action of heat. This is very important. It is a borax bead test. Action of heating, we call it as what? Borax bead test. So let us see what is a borax bead test. What is the action of heat on this borax? See, if you take the borax Na2B4O7 on heating, first what happened? It swells up. It swells by losing this, it has 10 water molecules. So after we heat it, what happened? The all 10 water molecules will lost. So that what happened? It will swells up. If it is a swelling up, the volume increases. If the volume increases, what happened? The density decreases. So one point you should remember, when we heat the borax and convert it into swells up, what happened? The density. So the density of the borax decreases because of swelling up, the density decreases. If you, even after the swelling up, if you further heat, what happened? We are getting sodium metaborate NaBO2 and a boric oxide. Also we call it as boron fescue oxide. Okay, sodium metaborate and B2O3. And this sodium metaborate and B2O3, these two combine together and they form what? Beads they form. Okay, they solidifies into, beads. And based upon the color of the bead, we will detect what? Cations. And one more thing, the color of the bead is not because of the anion. The color of the bead is because of cation. Suppose the cation is colorless, then definitely the beads are also colorless. Okay, so here an important point. The color of bead is due to the color of cation. Why? Because the metaborate ions are what? Colorless. So for example, if you take CuBO2 twice, copper borate. What is the color of copper borate? Blue in color. And even cobalt also, cobalt borate also, deep blue color. Deep blue color. That color is because of what? Metal ions, not because of anions. So this is what? Reaction with the heat, also called what? Borax beam test. Okay, so once again, when the borax and heating, first of all, it swells up because of loss of water. Okay, because of the swelling up, the volume increases, so the density decreases. Thereafter, if we further heating, what happens? It gives in the transparent liquid, and this transparent liquid, after some time, it will there is nothing but sodium metaborate and B2O3. And after some time, this transparent liquid will be solidifies into beads. And based upon the color of the bead, we will detect what? We will determine what are the cations present in the solution. Okay, so this is what borax bead test. We move to the next compound, that is what? Argboric acid. Argboric acid. What is the formula? H3BO3. This is also, we call it as, we will represent as BOH3. Argboric acid also represented with the BOH3. Yes, one important point you should remember, that H3BO3, okay, H3BO3, it is not a protonic acid. What do you mean by the protonic acid? It is not an acid normal like the acids which are where it's H plus ions. Protons we call as acids according to Arrhenius or Bronsted theory. But the argboric acid will not liberate any H plus ions. So that is why it is not a protonic acid, and it is not a Bronsted acid. Bronsted acid, it is a monobasic weak Lewis acid. So very 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 important. It is not a protonic acid, it is not a Bronsted acid, it is what? It's a monobasic. Monobasic means it gains what? One pair of electrons. Monobasic weak Lewis acid. Okay, so, and how can we say it's a monobasic weak Lewis acid? It's just again what? BOH3. It's an electron deficient. Why? Because it has only 6 electrons surrounding the boron. So to get the stability, it needs 2 more electrons. So it gains the 2 more electrons in the form of OH minus, and finally we are getting BOH4 minus. So it is accepting how many pairs of electrons? One pair of electrons from OH2. So that it is forming what? Tetrahedral unit. It is becoming stable. So that is why it is a weak monobasic Lewis acid. Okay, next, coming to the boric acid. If you check the boric, how can we prepare the boric acid? Let us see. Already in the borax we discuss the preparation of boric acid. How? Simply, when the aqueous solution of boric acid reacts with any acid. Why? Because it's an aqueous solution, is basic now, because of the presence of any OH. So when we add the acid here, when the aqueous solution of borax reacts with HCl, we are getting NaCl by the formation of H3BO3. So this is one of the method of preparation. The first one from borax, Na2B4O7.5H2O.HCl gives 2 moles of NaCl plus 4 moles of boric acid. This is one method. And one more method, whenever the any boron compound, you take any boron compound, boron halide, boron oxide, boron hydride, whatever it means, you take any boron compound, when you hydrolyze any boron compound, you will get a boron hydride, boric acid. You take for example BCl3, you take this on hydrolysis, we will get BOH3. Suppose if you take boric B2O3, boron oxide, so this on hydrolysis, okay, again we are getting BOH3. Next one, if you take diborane also, B2H6, this on hydrolysis, so we are getting, what we are getting? BOH3 by the liberation of hydrogen. Okay, like this. So many. So any boron compound, on hydrolysis, we get argboric acid. Okay, so this is what the preparation methods. Next, properties. What are the properties of argboric acid? Already in the name itself, it is in a weak acidic nature. And like borax, it is also a white crystalline solid. It is a white crystalline solid, but remember that it is a soapy to touch. So you know, caroms, you play the caroms, right? In the caroms, we will use boric acid. Because of its soapy nature, the caroms can easily move from one place to another place. So it is a white crystalline solid and it is a soapy in touch. Soapy in touch. Okay. And one more thing, coming to the solubility, it is less soluble. It is less soluble in cold water. Boric acid is less soluble in cold water, but highly soluble in hot water. Less soluble in cold water, but highly soluble in hot water. Suppose if you take on heating BOH thrice, boric acid on heating up to 373. Let us consider 373. Okay, so we will get metaboric acid, means HBO2, metaboric acid. This on further heating more than 373 Kelvin, so we will get B2O3. So this is about the properties of boric acid. Okay, and because of its acidic nature, one more thing, the boric acid, it can be reactive with the bases as we know. So that is what, because of its acidic nature, weak acidic nature, BOH thrice can react with the bases like NaOH, Na2CO3, MgOH twice. It can react with any bases. Okay, fine. Because of its acidic nature, it is reacting with the base, means okay, fine. And one exception case here, you should remember that boric acid not only reacts with the bases, it also reacts with the strong acid like HF. Okay, the BOH, it also reacts with HF, only HF. Okay, only HF, not all acids. Okay, it reacts with only HF and they forms what? BF3. Okay, it can react with a higher HF and we will get BF3. Okay, these are further reaction with the HF. Okay, we are getting what? BF6 minus 3 also we are getting. That's different. Okay, anyhow, it can react with only HF. It will not react with any other acids. Only it will react with the strong acid like only HF, and they use what? BF3 acid. Reaction properties of boric acid. Structure of boric acid. So till now we discussed the preparation method and the properties of boric acid. And now the structure of boric acid. If you look into the structure of boric acid in the solid state, so as we know, BOH thrice. So surrounding the boron, so like this, the three oxygen atoms are surrounding each boron atom in a trigonal planar form. Okay, so now what you will do, exactly this is one plane. In that plane you draw one more. Similarly, to this oxygen's plane you draw one more. Similarly, these two oxygens you draw one more. Okay, now the structure is what? BOH thrice. So between the two oxygen atoms, one hydrogen definitely. That means each boronate unit is bonded with what? H bonds, hydrogen bonds. Now let us be bond with. So normal bond, hydrogen bond. If this is a hydrogen bond, then this bond should be normal bond. Like this, you connect these all with H bonds. So this is the actual structure of boric acid. Now they may ask you the question, in solid state the H3BO3 units are bonded with what? H bonds. And each boric acid molecule, each molecule is involved in how many H bonds? That is the question. Suppose you take this is the central one boron atom. I am taking BOH. This is one molecule. Now this OH, here one H bond, here one H bond, here two. Next, here also 2, here also 2. Total, each molecule is involving in how many H bonds? 6 H bonds. So that is the point you should remember. So each BOH3 unit, each BOH3 unit is involving in 6 H bonds formation. 6 H bonds formation. Okay, so on the remaining as it is. So this is about the structure of boric acid. Next, let us move to the most important toxic, okay, toxic and colorless gas, okay, and easily catch the fire. So what is the gas? Diboric, let us discuss. So diboric, first of all, let us start with borates. Borates are nothing but what? Hydrides of boron, we call it as what? Borates. Hydrides of boron, we call it as borates. And the borates are of two types. Borates are of two types. What are those? One is nidoborane. Nidoborane. And the second one is arachnoborane. Arachnoborane. Nidoborates are nothing but the general formula BnHn plus 4. BnHn plus 4. Then if the formula, the general formula is BnHn plus 4, then that is called nidoborane. If the general formula is BnHn plus 6, then that is what? Arachnoborane. Now tell me, diborane, what is the structure? What is the formula of diborane? B2H6. B2H6. Now tell me, this is the form of nido or arachnoborane? This is what? B2, n value 2. 2 plus 4, 6. So this is what? It's an example of nidoborane. Diborane is a type of nidoborane. Now, let us discuss the diborane, B2H6. First, let us start with the preparation of, and one more thing, B2H6 is what? Toxic, colorless, okay, and easily catch fire. Physical properties, Manisha. Toxic, colorless, and easily catching fire. Okay, that is a just remember. Next, come to the preparation of diborane. We can prepare this diborane by using what? BF3, boron trifluoride. When this boron trifluoride on reduction with the HI, or else lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, if you reduce the BF3 with the HI or lithium aluminium hydride, what happened? HI means from this reduction, hydrogens will go and replace this. So BH3, two units will dimerize and will produce what? Sodium iodine intake. Sodium hydride. Not HI, sodium hydride. So when the BF3 on reduction with the sodium hydride, now Na plus to H minus. These H minus ions will go and replace them and we are getting B2H6. Okay, so this is what B2H6, and what is the byproduct? NaF will come. So this is what first preparation. Next, when BF3 on reduction with the lithium aluminium hydride, we will get borane B2H6 plus LiF plus AlF3. Byproducts lithium fluoride and aluminium fluoride also will produce. So this is one preparation method. This is what laboratory method of preparation. Next one, BCl3 on reduction in the presence of electrical discharge. Boron trifluoride and ferrite reduction with the in the presence of electrical discharge also we will get diborane plus HCl also will come as a byproduct. And the next one, third one, When sodium borohydride, this on oxidation with iodine. Okay, here iodine is acting as what? Oxidizing agent. So when sodium borohydride on oxidation with iodine also, we will get diborane. Okay, B2H6 and sodium iodide plus hydrogen will come. So this is what, these are the main methods of preparation of diborane. Okay, next, coming to the after the preparation methods, Let us move to the properties, chemical properties, let us discuss. Chemical properties. In that, the chemical properties, the first one, reaction with trialkyl ammonia and CO. Trimethyl ammonia and CO, carbon monoxide. As we know, they both are what? Lewis bases. Why? Because they are having what? Lone pairs of electrons. Okay, because of having the excess electrons in the form of lone pairs of electrons, they act as the Lewis bases. But dipole is what? Electron deficient species. They always accept electron from them. So what happened? When they react with a trimethyl ammonia or carbon monoxide, what happened? Homolysis takes place. That means when B2H6 on reaction with the trialkyl ammonia, okay, we are getting 2 moles of BH3NR3 adductive ion. That means the dimer will homolytically cleaved into monomer. But the monomer is what? Electron deficient. And that electron deficient monomer will accept the electron from ligand and they form a D2 bond. So there was a D2 bond between them. So like this, they are forming adduct. Same in the case of COs. Why? Because CO is also ligand. So B2H6, CO, we are getting what? 2 moles of BH3CO will come. So here also, it is also adduct. So here, which cleavage is taking place? Homolysis takes place. Homolysis of diborate takes place. So this is the reaction with the trialkyl ammonia and carbon monoxide. Next one, reaction with ammonia. What we have? Reaction with ammonia. So when we react the diborane with ammonia, B2H6 reacts with ammonia. So what will happen? First of all, let us have drawing like this. First of all, it will form an ionic compound. So how it is forming ionic compound? Let us see. So this is the structure of diborane. For our reference, I am drawing. We will discuss this structure later. So this is the structure of diborane. Now what happened? When the diborane reacts with ammonia, here cleavage takes place. Cleavage takes place. So this part will come out as what? BH4-. And to this part, the two ammonia ligands will donate. And this part will come out as what? Cation. So the structure is, so in this part, how many hydrogens are there? Two are there. So that is why BH2NH3 twice plus ion, cation. And this species will come out as an anion. That is what? BH4-. Like this, we are getting an ionic species. Now this ionic species on further heating, we are getting B3N3H6. What we call this one? B3N3H6. This is what we call it as borazole or borazine or inorganic benzene. B3N3H6 is also we call it as inorganic benzene. And when you compare this benzene and inorganic benzene, that means benzene C6H6 and inorganic benzene B3N3H6, when you compare these two, which is more reactive, which is more polar? So definitely inorganic benzene is more reactive than benzene. What is the reason? In benzene there was no polar bonds, CC bonds are only there. There was no polarity. But in case of inorganic benzene BN, there was an electronegativity difference. So definitely there was a polar bonds. If there was a polar bond, then they are more reactive. So that is why inorganic benzene is more reactive than what? Benzene. Okay. Next, one more important point you should remember. So generally, JE means they will ask you the question. When inorganic benzene on substitution, means suppose if there was a halogenation, how many of disubstituted products will form? That is the question. When inorganic benzene, if you look at the structure of the inorganic benzene, the structure will be like this.
So this is the structure of inorganic benzene. Here how many have hydrogens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 hydrogens are there.
Now, when this inorganic benzene on dihalogenation, how many of disubstituted products are produced? Remember that total 4 dihalo substituted products are produced. How many disubstituted products? 4 disubstituted products are produced. So this is about the inorganic benzene. Next, this is the reaction with ammonia. Next, on hydrolysis, when B2H6 on hydrolysis, so what we will get? BOH thrice will come and hydrogens will liberate. So this is what on hydrolysis of diborane. Next, this borane, diborane, the diborane on reaction with metal hydrides. Metal hydrides, what are the products will come? It's very very important question. What is the product formed when the diborane reacts with metal hydrides? Metal hydrides means LiH, NaH, cesium hydride, like this. So in this all M plus H minus. Okay, so when these metal hydrides reacts with a BH3 units, diborane. So now what, tell me what happened? I think you will get an idea. See, so in this BH3, this is electron deficient. To get the stability, they both are joining together and they form diborane. Okay, suppose if they are reacting with the hydrides, what is the role of hydrides? Hydride H minus, they have excess electrons. So that is why it transfer the H minus from here to here. So BH3 becomes what? BH4 minus. So that we are getting metal borohydrides will come. Metal borohydrides will come. So, for example, lithium hydride, if it is LiBH4, if it is sodium hydride, NaBH4, so like this, metal borohydrides will come. So, these are the reaction chemical properties of diborane towards trialkyl ammonia and carbon monoxide, towards ammonia and towards hydrolysis, towards water and towards what? Metal hydrides. Okay. Next, structure of, if you look into the structure of this diborane, so in the structure, as we know, borane I am taking first, BH3 and one more borane. Okay, so this is one borane and this is another borane. For the formation, for each bond, how many electrons are there? 2 electrons are there. That means here 2 electrons, here also 2 electrons. Now what happened? To get the stability, what happened out of these 2 electrons, and these 2 electrons are shared by this bond also. Okay, so one of the electrons are transferred here and it forms what? Okay, partial bond. Similarly, these electrons, one electron was shared with this and they forms. Okay, now tell me, this is a bond which is formed by how many electrons now? This is a bond which is, these are the bonds which is formed by how many electrons? 2 electrons, only 2 electrons. But how many centers are involved? 1 boron, 1 hydrogen, 1 boron. Total how many centers? 3 centers are involved. So that is why this bond we call it as, what we call this one? 3 centered 2 electron bond. Okay, similarly, here this bond also, here 2 electrons are only involved but shared by 3 centers. So this is also we call it as what? 3 centered 2 electron bond. Total how many 3 centered 2 electrons or bonds are there? 2 3 centered 2 electron bonds are present. This 3 centered 2 electron bond, these bonds we call it as what? Bridge bond. Bridge bond, also called banana bond, also called tau bond. Bridge bond, banana bond or tau bond, all are same. Okay, and okay, this is about the bridge bonds. What about the remaining bonds? Remaining all bonds are what? 2 centered 2 electron bonds only remaining. So 1, 2, 3, 4, because 2 electrons are 2 centers. Okay, how many 2 centered 2 electron bonds are there? 4 are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many 3 centered 2 electron bonds are there? 2 are there. Okay, now, so if you look at the structure completely again, BH3, and this is the complete structure of dipole. These are the two bridge bonds and these are the four terminal bonds. Now tell me, already in the AlCl3 structure we discussed. So this is X if you consider, this is a bond angle Y. Now tell me, among the X and Y, which is longer? X is longer. Why? Because the terminal bonds are, they can easily freely move. So the bond angle between the terminal bonds is greater. So X is greater than Y. Okay, next, one more point you should remember here. If you take the lengths, that is BH, terminal BH bond is A and the bridge BH bond is what? B if you compare. So definitely B is greater than A. So that's already we discussed in AlCl3. Once again. And one more point you should remember. How many of atoms are in the same plane? They may ask you the question. So in dipole, this is a 3 atoms are in the same plane. And even these 3 atoms are in the same plane. Okay, so total how many atoms are there in the same plane? 6 atoms are in the same plane. What about the 2 bridge hydrogens? So the 2 bridge hydrogens, one bridge hydrogen is above the plane, another bridge hydrogen is below the plane. So they both are out of planes. So total the question is, in dipole, how many atoms are in the same plane? How many are there? 6 atoms are in the same plane. One is above the plane, another one is below the plane. And what is the hybridization of boron in dipole? That is sp3 hybridization. You should remember this. Why? Because BH3, as per the hybridization formula, if you calculate, you will get what? BH3, what we will get? sp2 hybridization will come. So generally, we will do the mistake, that is why. But in fact, it is what? sp3 hybridized, because of the presence of bridge hydrogen bonds. Okay, suppose if the dipole on substitution, okay, how many substituted groups are there? For example, here total how many hydrogens are there? 6 hydrogens are there. Out of 6 hydrogens, how many will substitute by the group? So always remember that only terminal hydrogens only will be substituted, not bridge hydrogens. So total how many terminal hydrogens are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 terminal hydrogens are there, that is why only tetra substituted dipole only will come. So for example, if B2H6 on methylation, what happened? These methyl groups will go on substituting how many hydrogens? 4 only. So the compound formula will be B2H2ME4, not B2ME6. Don't be confused. Why? Because only terminal hydrogens one will be replaced with a substituting group. Okay.